Bottom tab navigation is a special type of navigation system in React Native, which allows the user to move from one screen to another screen. In bottom tab navigation, a horizontal bar will appear at the bottom of a screen. This horizontal bar will be divided into multiple tabs. When we click on any tabs like profile, it will display profile screen. When we click on cart tab, it will display cart screen. So in this tutorial, we will learn how to implement bottom tab navigation in React Native. The following four steps are used to implement bottom tab navigation in React Native. Step 1. Design the screen like home, profile, cart. Step 2. Install the packages which are required for implementing bottom tab navigation in React Native. Step 3. Add bottom tab navigation component into the home.js screen. Step 4. Run the app. Start the Visual Studio Code IDE. For this, click on Terminal menu, then New Terminal. Type the following command to create React Native app: react-native space init space app name. For example, my app name is bottom tab navigation, and press the enter key. After this, we have to open our app folder. For this, click on File menu, then Open folder. Select the folder and click on Select folder button. It will load the necessary files into the Project Explorer window. Now we have to create three screens: home, profile, and cart. For this, click on New File icon and enter the screen name like home.js and press the enter key. Now we have to type the basic structure of React Native screen: import React, component from React and semicolon, import view, text from React Native and semicolon. After this, we have to start the class export default class, then class name, which is home, extends component. Inside the class, define the render function, render, and this render function must return a value. Therefore, we have to use return a statement here, and inside the return we have to define our screen with the help of view object, and inside the view we have to display a message with the help of text component home screen. So this is our basic structure of our home screen. After this, we have to save this file and test it. For this, click on index.js and change the app name from app to home.js. Save the file and close it. Now click on terminal menu, new terminal, terminal menu, split terminal. Type the following command to launch the emulator: emulator dash avd space avd name, which is my avd, and press the enter key. Type the following command to run React Native app: react dash native space run dash android, and press the enter key. Our app is loading. So this is the basic output of our home screen. Now I am applying some type of formatting on this screen. For example, style equal to font size colon 40. Save the file. After this, we have to align the content of our screen. For this, I am applying style property on the view, style equal to flex colon 1 comma justify content colon inside the single quote center and align item colon center. Save the file. So this is our basically home screen. Similar, we have to create profile screen and cart screen. For this, copy the home.js and paste it. Change the file name profile change the class name profile and change the message . So this is our profile screen. After this, we have to save our file and we have to check or test this profile screen. For this, open the index.js and change the file name profile. Save the file and close it. So this is our profile screen. Now we have to create cart screen. Just copy the home.js and paste it. Rename the file cart.js. Change the class name from home to cart and also change the message. Save the card.js by pressing Ctrl S. After this, we have to check our card.js file. For this, open the index.js, change the file name card, save the file. So this is our card screen. So in this step, we have just create three screen: home.js, profile.js and card.js. Now we have to install some packages which are required for bottom tab navigation. For this, click on terminal menu, then new terminal. The first package is React Native Navigation package. For this, we have to type the following command: npm install space package name react-navigation space save and press the enter key. Now we have to install second package, which is React Native Gesture Handler. For this, we have to type the following command: npm install space package name react-native-gesture-handler space save and press the enter key. Now we have to install third package, which is React Navigation Material Bottom Tab. For this, we have to type npm install space React Navigation dash material dash bottom dash tabs space save and press the enter key. Now we have to install packages which are related to the icons. For this, type the following command: npm install space react-native-elements save and press the Enter key. Now we have to install React Native Vector Icons package. Now we have to install last package, which is React Native Paper. For this, type the following command: npm install space react-native-paper, save and press the Enter key. Now we have to manually link the following two packages. First package is React Native Element and second package is React Native Vector Icons. To link the package, type the following command: react-native link, after link specify the package name, which is React Native Elements. And press the Enter key. Similar, we have to link the second package, React Native Vector Icons. For this, we have to type react-native space link space package name, which is react-native-vector-icons and press the Enter key. After the successful installation of package, kindly ensure that these packages are installed in your project. For this, click on package.json file. Here you can find all the packages we have already installed, like React Native, React Native Element, React Native Gesture Handler, React Native Paper, React Native Vector Icons, React Navigation and React Navigation Material Bottom Tabs. If any of these packages are missing from the package.json file, kindly repeat your installation step. You can find all the package installation command into the video description. Now we have to set home.js as a default screen. For this, we have to open index.js, and inside the index.js we have to change our default screen name home. Save the file and close it. After this, we have to run our app. For this, we have to type the following command: react-native space run-android and press the Enter key. Now we have to add bottom tab navigation component into the home.js. For this, open the home.js file. We have to include three packages to implement bottom tab navigation in React Native. For this, we have to type import from inside the single quote, type React Navigation. React Navigation semicolon, and inside the bracket type create bottom tab navigator. Comma, create app container. After the first import statement, we have to import React Navigation Material Bottom Tab package. Import from inside the single quote, type React dash Native dash Material React Navigation Material Bottom Tab semicolon, and inside the bracket type create material bottom tab navigator. Now we have to import package which is required for icons. Import from React dash Native dash Elements semicolon, and inside the bracket we have to import icon. After import statement, we have to include all the screens which are required into the tab navigation. The first screen is home, second screen is profile, and third screen is cart. Therefore, we have to import profile from profile. Similarly, we have to import cart screen. Import cart from inside the single quotes cart. Into the next step, we have to remove export default statement from the home class. Into the next step, after the class definition, we have to define our tab navigation system. For this, we have to create a constant which contains all the tab, their formatting, and screen related information. For this, we have to create constant name like tab navigator, or you can define any name here, equal to create material bottom tab navigator function semicolon. This function contains objects of tab. And our first tab is for home screen. Therefore, we have to type home colon inside the curly bracket. We have to define screen colon. Our screen name for home is home, comma. After this, we have to set the navigation options like what is the name of tab, what is the color of tab, what is the background color of tab, what is the icon of tab. For this, we have navigation options property. Inside navigation options, we have to define all the tab related information like what is the label of tab, tab bar label colon, and inside the single quotes, we have to define the label for the tab 1, which is home, comma. What is the color of active tab? For this, we have active color property. active color colon. Inside the single quotes, we can define the color for tab hash FF0000, comma, inactive color of tab inactive color colon. Inside the single quotes, we can define the inactive color hash, which is black, comma. After this, we have to define the background color of tab. For this, we have bar style colon. Inside the curly bracket, we have to define the background color for the tab bar. Background color colon, any color like hash . So this is the background color of tab. After this, we have to define the icon for the tab. For this, we have tab bar icon property, and into the tab bar icon, we have to set arrow, then round bracket. And inside the round bracket, we have to define a view which contain icon. Therefore, we have to start view, and inside the view, we have to add icon component here. Inside the icon, we have to define what is the name of icon. For this, we have a name attribute, and inside the name attribute, we have to set the icon for the home. For this, we have a home space. After that, we have to set the size of icon, size equal to, inside the curly bracket, we have to define the size of icon like 25. The icon name must be in single quotes. After the size, we can also define the style for the icon, like style equal to, inside the curly bracket, we have to define the color for the style or color for the icon, like color colon like color name is FF0000, which is red. So this is our code for the first tab. Similarly, we have to define another tab for the profile. For this, type the semicolon. After this, we have just copy this code and paste it. The screen name is profile, label is profile, active color and inactive color, bar style, and icon name for the profile is person. Similar, we have third tab for the cart screen. Just copy the code and paste it. The third screen is cart. Screen name is cart. Tab caption is cart. And icon name is add shopping cart. remove the semicolon from the last tab. After the definition of tab navigator, we have to set export default statement. For this, we have to type export default space create app container, and inside the create app container we have to pass tab navigator object semicolon. So this is our complete code for the bottom tab navigation. Now we have to set the curly bracket here. Similar, we have to set double curly bracket with the style. So this is our complete code for the bottom tab navigation. Into the first step, we have to import all the packages. Into the second step, we have import all the screens. Into the third step, we have to remove export default statement from the class. Into the next step, we have to define tab navigator object. This tab navigator object contain all the tabs like home, profile and cart. Every tab object has screen name, tab related formattings like label, background color and icons. After this, we have to save our file by pressing Ctrl S. Here you can see that bottom tab navigation bar appear on our screen. When I click on profile, it will display profile screen. When I click on cart, it will display cart screen. So in this tutorial we have learned how to add bottom tab navigation in React Native.